This year's fifth Dominican Book Fair, being held at Boricua College, is dedicated to writer and literary critic and activist Dr. Franklin Gutierrez. The event is being held to promote U.S. bilingual communities the opportunity to learn and study the rich Dominican culture. Well, several generations of artists and poets and songwriters will be showcasing their talents that include poetry, music, hip-hop, most of all, spoken word. Alba Mota, Principal Coordinator of Board of Health Commission, and she's here, and she stops by to dish a little bit more on this very special event, and good to have you.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. So tell us a little bit about this event now.
Sure. This is an event organized by the Dominican Commissioner of Culture, which has a presence in the United States, specifically New York, and this is the fifth book fair, which the slogan is, "Reading makes you different." Mm-hmm. And it's, like you said, dedicated to a former commissioner and activist, Franklin Gutierrez. And this year is very special because we're having a bilingual format. Mm-hmm. It's the first time we're going to bring English spoken words in English and poetry. Oh. So we're really excited about that. Also, we're bringing hip-hop, I mean, spirituality, which is one of the topics that I specifically was interested in because our youth out there, usually we're not part of this traditionally. Mm-hmm. So one of my complaints when I volunteered last year was like, where are the youth? I'm not the only one, right? Mm-hmm. They're like, okay, since you're complaining, you're the one organizing this year youth section. So we're gonna have Dominican American spoken word artist, Guatemalan American Walter Mercado, which he's an author. Mm-hmm. He just wrote a book, which I wrote a copy of it. Rammer, he's Dominican American, and Ethiopian American, his name is Tefaye Neguzi, which is a great spoken word artist.
So what do you want people to take away from this event? After they've had the experience of being there, what do you want people to go home and say?
And say, we are a rich community with diversity, with art, with talented young people, with the magic of making things happen when we get together. And that's expressing art through the lyrics, through books, and also we're going to have other, besides books and poetry, we're going to have also live sculptures. Mm-hmm. That's an artist from the Dominican Republic that's coming to, with human beings, he's going to put together sculptures.
Talk to me about this, because literary, being, the whole literary field and getting people more involved in the literary work, because obviously a lot of people in this day, in this culture, sadly enough to admit, illiterate or under reading level. You guys have really taken a strong approach of really trying to make things a little bit better.
Definitely, because people, the excuse is like, and we could understand in this business society, they don't have time for reading. Yes, you do. If you take a topic that really interests you, that's why we're bringing hip-hop, because a lot of the young people, they want to learn about hip-hop, about spoken words. That's like what is out there for young people. So that was kind of the bait for me to like also bring that young generation that unfortunately are kind of lazy to read. And that's really critical because reading is important at many levels for our young people.
Mm-hmm. So you also have another event. Talk about the Border Health Mission.
Yes, it's an organization that I co-founded in 2008 when the hurricanes hit Haiti and the Dominican Republic. Since I was involved with the Dominican-Haitian issue here, I was able to organize different dialogues in 2006 and 2008. I was like, okay, I wanted to beyond just talking, beyond doing conferences. So we organized the first Border Health Mission and traveled to Haiti and then to the border of Haiti and the Dominican Republic. And since then, we've been going every year, delegation of professionals, doctors, teachers, social workers. We bring art and theater to the children. Our languages, we teach English, Haitian Creole, and Spanish to the kids. And last year we implemented, because of the earthquake, holistic medicine massage, reflexology, and Reiki.
Wow. Talk to us about that relationship between the Dominican Republic and Haiti, being right there. And I know we're coming up on the 2-year anniversary of Haiti. You've been down to, do some assistance and helping out like that. What is the relationship now between the Dominican community and the Haitian community?
If we talk about the relationship over there, historically we had a fabricated conflict. We shared the same island, which the western side was occupied by France, and the eastern side by Spain. And unfortunately, the divide and conquer formula has worked very well in the island. So Haitians and Dominicans, and I'm not going to say it's the whole population that had that conflict.
Right.
At some level, there's collaboration with the work about the human rights abuses that the Haitians received from Dominicans in the Dominican Republic. But there's also Dominicans fighting against that. Mm-hmm. Here, the community is trying to work together. I had built a strong relationship and collaboration with some activists in Brooklyn, Haitian activists, mm-hmm. and they support the work that I do. And they actually go with us to the border every year. We had Dr. Fran Desire that's go with us, Dr. Henry Fran that has given us a lot of support in terms of medicines. So the collaboration has been very, very tight.
Wow, amazing. So if we wanted to find out more information about Border Health Mission, what do people do?
They could email or check the website. The email is amota@funtosalu.org. But you could also email me bordermission@gmail.com. And our website is www.funtosalu, and it was F.
Okay.
FuntoSaludInternational.org.
As a matter of fact, you see some of the emails right there at the bottom of the screen. You see it at the bottom of the screen right now, and you can just drop down right there and get that information right there. So once again, I want to tell you about this, the fifth annual literary festival, Dominican Book Fair, being held at Boricua College. I want you to come on out and be a part of that. Final words, what do you want people to know?
To please come and support that. If also they want to share their poetry during the hip-hop spirituality session of it, they could come and do so. It's going to start at 1:45 on Saturday. It's a whole day event. And on Sunday, we're going to have immigrant women voices also sharing their poetry. And if you want to share your poetry, you could come and do so and buy books. Come and support those writers that are writing from the heart so you could enjoy their literature. And also, one of our, like I said, our feature writers is Walter Hidalgo, which just come up with this book, Beyond the Four Walls, The Rising Ministry and Spirituality of Hip Hop.
All right, Alba Mota, thank you so much for coming and sharing with us.
You're welcome.
All righty, well, we encourage you to stay tuned and you'll find out more information about what is going on in and around our community. But as we said, the fifth Dominican Book Fair is actually being held at Boricua College. Get that information at the bottom of the screen.